Lamb is not. Look at this. This is David speaking about God and how God has illumined his understanding. And it is a light for my path. You know, it takes light to illumine darkness. Light dispels darkness. You know, if you come in this building at, say, 10 o'clock at night, you don't even have to come in here that late. You can come in here around 6 o'clock. And if it's dark outside, it's black in here.
Amen.
Because there's no light in here. But as soon as I flip the switch, the light dispels the darkness.
Yeah.
The whole place lights up. Guess what? There's three lights out up here right now. But guess what? The place is lit up. And if you turn the light off and turn the switch off and the lights in the back, guess what? The daylight outside lights the place up.
That's right. Amen.
David is saying here that your word is light.
That's right.
Because Jesus was the light of the world. And Jesus said that we would be the light of the world.
Amen.
He told us he wanted us to be light and salt in the earth.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
People could see what? Him.
Him.
So people could see him. That's why we're the light of the world. You ain't, listen, you ain't the light of the world because he wants people to see you.
Amen.
He's not putting you on the scene and putting you on spotlight and putting you out there. He wants people to see him working through you. That's it. He's light. And if people don't see us resembling Christ, guess what? They don't see nothing.
Amen.
I wait for the message. Amen. 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 Y'all say, why? Wait a minute, Pastor. You're not talking about me, are you? If the shoe fits. If they don't see you exhibiting love, exhibiting joy, exhibiting peace,
come on, God.
Goodness. Kindness, long-suffering, those are the fruit of the Spirit. Jesus told his disciples, you can tell a tree by the fruit that it bears. So guess what he was doing? He was making a distinction, because what he was probably saying was, there's some Pharisees in the audience. And so I'm going to show y'all what's real fruit, fruit from God, and what's bad fruit, because he was making a distinction. Now, here's my point. Here's my point. I want y'all to see the light of this, because you need to know today that there's a gift that God has given to us.
Amen.
So that we won't be in the dark.
Amen.
Just in case you believe it, that we are in the dark, I'm going to show you that we're not in the dark. Okay, and I don't want to really go over all my notes, but let me do a quick overview real quick of just what discernment is, because if I can use for a subject matter, it is discernment matters. And what all the other things that matter to you, discernment matters. Let me give you the definition of what discernment is, and I'll show you in a couple of verses of scripture in the Bible why I'm talking about this subject, because I want you in this 21-day fast to learn how to start focusing on what's around you, who's around you. I want your awareness to be heightened. I want you to be able to start seeing stuff that you've never seen before, hearing stuff that you don't want to hear. Now, have you been around people and you've heard stuff that you don't want to hear? That's because God wants you to hear it. I wish I had some praying people. That's because God wants you to know those people just a little bit better than you think you know them. I wish I had some praying people. I'll make sense in a minute. But let me first and foremost give you the definition of discernment. This is what discernment is. It is the ability to look beneath the surface to see reality. That's what discernment is.
My God.
Okay, let me give that to you again, because Deke looked like he looked like he was puzzled. It is the ability to look beneath the surface.
My God.
To see reality. Look how many people live in some type of fantasy world.
Look out, man.
In our earth today.
Wow.
All the television shows on TV or reality shows, but how much of that stuff is true and how much of it is fake? Mm-hmm. Now, we think that the majority of it is real, but guess what? It's not.
Fake.
NFL ain't real.
Fake.
I wish I had some prank people in here. NBA ain't real. WWE ain't real. It's worldwide entertainment. And that's because they do it to put on a show, because they want to entertain you and take your money.
That's right.
And so you go to the wrestling match to see acrobats.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's right. Because, you know, they closed Ringling Brother Brown and Bailey Circus down. So you ain't going to see no more acrobats and no more flying and people, you know. You ain't going to see that no more because they set the circus down. But if you want to see a circus, go to wrestling, WWE. And you'll be entertained.
That's right.
From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, you'll be entertained.
That's right.
I'm
just asking.
Woo!
Rick Flair.
Woo! They thought he was the prettiest man in the world. If you see him right now, that plastic surgeon.
That's the number.
But listen, it is, watch this. It involves evaluating information or situations. This is what discernment is. It involves evaluating information or situations, recognizing differences. Do y'all recognize different stuff around y'all? I can tell y'all right now, wives in here recognize different stuff about their husbands. Because guess what? Guess what? They see stuff we don't see.
Well, well, well.
Amen.
You know why? Because we're predictable.
Oh,
dude. And they change. That's like that. Women change their minds. That's like that.
Yeah.
They can say, hey, honey, let's go over here.
Right.
No, I want to go over there.
Yep.
No, let's go over there. They can do that. Just like that. Whereas a man is like, let's go right here. And that's it. And guess what? That woman knows that he was going to do that because he's predictable.
Yeah.
Differences, though. My point is, can you tell the difference? When somebody really loves you and when they don't care nothing about you.
Mm.
Can you tell the difference of folk faking it? To make it around you, they faking around you, but they don't really care nothing about you. They try to get everything and anything they can get out you. And once they use you and it's over, it's done.
It's done. You moved it out.
Can you tell the difference? Can you tell the difference in this world, this era of history, from back in the days?
Yeah.
Some of us in here remember back in the
days,
in the 70s, in the 60s, those days are gone. In the 80s and the 90s, those days are over. We're in a techno age now. Yeah. Everything is different.
Right? Yeah.
And it's evolving and it's changing every day. Can you tell the difference?
Yeah.
All right. This is discernment. Discernment is recognizing differences. Watch this. Considering consequences and thereby making sound judgment. Watch this. Do you consider the consequences? I've always told the church this, especially my leadership. I've always told them this. I've always said this. No matter what you do, whether it's right or wrong, there's always two things that's going to catch you. And you'll never get away. And you can never plan it, Troy, in the scheme of things and what you're doing. You can never plan it. And the reason why is because you have no control over it. It's called hidden consequences. And it's called future consequences. It's going to catch you.
Yep.
Either way, the consequences are going to get you.
Amen.
God has something already. He put a mechanism into our so-called plans or preparations and stuff we do. And that's why people like, what was the guy that did the Ponzi scheme? Didn't get away with it.
Nope.
But he got billions of dollars.
Madoff.
He got people's money. Got billions of dollars and didn't get away with it. Went to penitentiary. So how you gonna enjoy billions of dollars in penitentiary and then die? Then the son turned around and died. You ain't gonna get away with it. I don't care what you, people that murder people and kill people and think that they've gotten away with it, watch this. It eats them up so bad, Tony, eventually what happens is they got to come and turn themselves in 20 years later. That's what they do. They come and turn themselves in because their conscience has eaten them up that they took a life and they thought they got away. And God wore on their lives and minds so hard, they had to come and turn themselves in. All the consequences, Jesus Christ. That was deep when God gave it about 5-6 years ago. He said there's hidden consequences and future consequences. So I said to myself, well, God, I can't even get away from you.
Nope.
I can't do nothing.
Nope.
Ain't no need of doing nothing in secret.
Nope.
Because you got something waiting for me up ahead. I wish I had some.
Amen.
And so let me give you real quick, because this might be a part three. Let me give you real quick. Some scriptures. Let's look at these scriptures before I go into these 8 points, because I really want to make 8 points as to why you need this gift of discernment. Let's first look at 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 5c, because I want you to see why you need to be able to discern and why discernment matters. And then I'm going to try to get through these 8 points. If I don't get through them all, it'll be a part 3, because I'm trying to do this, and I want you to get as much as you can without me having to miss anything, or without me, because I want to show you how you can get discernment after this. But I want to go through these 8 points. But look at this in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, and look at verse 5, and look at verse 5c, because you know when you have a verse of scripture in the Bible, and you have maybe 4 or 5 different paraphrases or the lines, it goes A, B, C, down like that. So 5C is this. Here's 5C. Here's what 5C says in 1 Corinthians chapter 4. He will bring to light what is hidden in darkness, talking about Jesus, talking about God, and will expose the motives of men's hearts. At that time, each will receive his praise from God. Mm. It says that he will, whatever is done in the dark, will surely come to the light.
Right.
He's going to light it up.
That's right.
That's why you see stuff happening the way it does. God lights it up. What he does is he's exposing whatever is done in the dark and you think you've gotten away with it. He says it right here. Because he exposes the motives of men's hearts.
Yes.
That's what it says. And so go over here to 2 Corinthians real quick. Let me help you out. And verse 4. And look at verse 4, and let me show you why you need to discern and why it's so important to discern. Because if you don't know, you have an adversary. There is an enemy working against you 24/7. It is his job. He is called the Terminator. You know what a Terminator is?
Yeah.
It is something that won't stop until you are dead or destroyed or defeated. And he is our adversary, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in high places. And so look at what Paul says concerning the Corinthians. In 2 Corinthians 4:4, look at what he says about man. Watch this. The God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers. Notice it didn't say he's blinded the mind of believers. You know why? Because we are children of light and we're walking in the light. But guess what? Everybody that's not in Christ are out of it.
Yeah.
Walking in the darkness. Watch this. Blinded the minds of unbelievers so that they cannot see the light. There it is. There it is. Discernment. See the light of the gospel. Watch this. Of the gospel. Of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. They can't even see who Christ is because of the fact that Satan has blinded them. Mm-hmm. He has distracted them.
Right.
You can't look beneath nothing and see beneath nothing. You can't see the real reality of something because of the fact that Satan has blinded you. You're blinded. Yep. You can't see. And so if you ever wonder why people do what they do and do the things that they do, this is the answer right here. It's because they're blinded.
Uh-huh.
I wish I had some friends, but that's why you shouldn't be talking about nobody.
Gossiping
about people, because guess what? They're under a spell. If you don't believe me, I just showed it to you. They are under a spell, and they're under a terrible spell too. And this ain't no roots, and this ain't no voodoo. They're under the power of Satan himself. He has blinded them. They can't see the forest for the trees. They can't see the green. They can't see it. Because guess what? He's made an illusion, Lisa. Y'all seen David Bland. When y'all see David Bland, he is not a magician like David Copperfield. He is a warlock.
Yeah.
He does real magic. David Bland is a warlock. He is from Satan himself. He does real stuff.
Yeah.
When you look at him, you ain't looking at David Copperfield. He gives you illusion. But David Bland can levitate himself off the ground. I've seen him resurrect a bird from the dead. Yeah. He does stuff like that.
Yeah.
He pushes nickels and quarters and dimes through glass pane windows and stuff, with people on the other side catching deaths of the devil, y'all. I wish I had some praying people to hear. Y'all ain't got to believe me. I'm trying to tell you right now, God says that the God of this age has blinded people. Know how he gets you? He distracts you.
Amen.
He gives you all kinds of distractions. He sends all kinds of foolishness your way. Yes. Stuff he know that you can't handle, so he can rock you and shake you to the core. So he can mess you up, and hopefully you may just lose your mind. If Satan could have his way to destroy you, he would want you to lose your mind so that he could possess your soul.
Amen.
God says here, though, he's got the unbelievers. They can't see. They can't discern because they can't see because they're blinded. So if you wonder why people keep doing the same stuff over and over again, why they keep doing drugs, why they keep drinking alcohol, why they keep doing stuff over and over and over again, because they're putting a band-aid on the problem.
Yeah.
I wish I had some breakthrough. And that's why you have to pray for people because Satan has them blinded. They can't see.
Yeah.
They don't understand it. You always thinking to yourself, yes, they do understand, Pastor. They got to know right from wrong. Yes, they do morally know right from wrong, but that doesn't mean that they make that their conscious choice.
Amen.
I'll get ready to preach to y'all now. Listen, the reason why people do what they do is because Satan has a grip on them.
Yeah.
Amen.
Satan has his hold on them.
Hold on.
Amen.
Says right there that he has come to blind them. Right. They are blinded and they can't see.
Can't see it.
They can't see. That's why we need to stay on our knees and pray.
Yes.
You know, she's been on her knees because folks are calling her this new year. And praise the Lord doing this 21-day fast because guess what? They need your prayers.
Yes,
I wait for the amens to die down. We don't never know how God is using us in the scheme of things. Guess what? Whatever it is, it's people calling on you for. If they're calling on you for prayer, if they're calling on you for counseling, you be that light and that salt because you don't know if they're going to die the next minute. That's how serious it is. You see, we take it for a joke. We take it lightly as if, you know, it ain't nothing. They're just going through. No, they ain't just going through. Satan's got his grip on
them.
They can't even make an intelligent decision.
That's right.
Because if they could, Lisa, guess what? They would have.
Yes, sir.
When the boy was eating the pig slop, guess what? God gave him enough clear conscience.
You know.
I wish I had some brain people here. To make an intelligent decision, I need to get up from here. My dad would probably hire me if I go back and tell him I'm sorry. I can at least get 3 meals and wear some clean clothes, and I'll just be a servant in this house.
Yeah.
God, man, I'm talking about the prodigal son. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That boy made an intelligent decision. I need to get out from here.
Get up.
I was not designed or made for this.
No, I haven't missed
it. Didn't know that his daddy was already waiting on him.
Didn't know
his daddy was going to accept him and approve him. Already had approved him. God is still waiting on some of y'all.
Amen.
Waiting to approve you. Still waiting on you. With his arms open, wide open. But y'all making the choice and the decision to let Satan distract you.
Amen.
Distractions everywhere.
Yeah, you talk.
Says blinded them from the gospel. They can't see. So let me give you what James chapter 1 says. Real quick, and then I'm going to try to go through these. I have 8 points I want to make why discernment matters, because you need to be discerning this morning. James chapter 1, verses 5 and 6 says this, and so you need to understand why you need to discern and why it matters, because James gives us the answer. Watch what it says right here. In James chapter 1, verse 5, it says, if any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God. It didn't say ask the pastor.
Nope.
It didn't say come to the deacons.
That's right.
It didn't say go to Shania because she can sing or she'll play a song that'll give you the answer. It said you should ask God. Don't go to your husband. Don't go to your wife.
That's right.
It didn't say go to your mama. It didn't say go to your daddy.
That's right.
It said go to God.
Go to God.
If you lack wisdom.
That's right.
Because there's two types of wisdom. There's world wisdom. And it's heavenly wisdom. Watch this though. Goes on to say this, because this is deep. I want y'all to get it now. It says, who gives generously to all without finding fault? He'll give it to you.
Yeah.
He wants to give it to you and pour it out on you.
Yeah.
And it will be given to him, who the person who asks. Watch this. But he who asks He must believe and not doubt. Because he who doubts is like the wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. And so guess what? If you don't have faith in God when you ask him for wisdom, you don't even need to ask him.
No, no.
Because guess what? If you doubt him, you've already fumbled the ball.
That's
you lost.
Right, that's right.
You already lost the game. You fumbled the ball. Because if you ask him something, you ought to have faith and believe that he's going to give you the answer.
That's right.
Because it says it right there. If you don't have, look, I ain't the smartest man in the world. I ain't no rocket science. By no means. I wasn't even a straight A student. I was an AB honor roll student. But still, guess what? I don't have all the answers, but I know who does. And the Bible clearly tells me that if I need an answer to something that's going on, whether it's my marriage, see, I ain't got to go to none of y'all and say, look, you know what? This is what's happening with me and Tina, and I just don't know what to do. Could you please inform me? I don't have to go to you, but I can go to my God.
Amen.
Hey, my children acting up, blah, 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 blah. You know, you've got 20 children. What do I do? You know, because I only got two. I don't have to go to you. Well, my finances, you know, every time I turn around, Pastor, I'm broke. Okay, you know what? It says clearly in the scriptures, if you bring tithes and offerings to the storehouse,
that's right,
that he will make room for you.
Yes, yes, sir.
That he'll open up a window for
you. Yes, he will.
That he'll do it for you.
Yes, he will.
It didn't say go to the pastor. Amen. But Pastor, what advice do you have for me? I'm going to take you right to the word of God.
That's
what I tell you. When you come to me, and most of y'all won't come to me because you know I'm going to take you to the word of God.
Amen.
And I'm going to pray for you.
Yeah.
Because guess what? That's the answer. That's it. You got it. That's the answer. Okay. All right. So you need to be able to discern. Now, the only way, because it's a gift from God, the only way you're going to get it is you got to be in Christ.
Amen.
Because people in the world that's unbelievers, they don't know no better. I want people to get this. They don't know no better. They are blinded.
Blind.
Yes, they know right from wrong, but they don't know no better. And some of them can't even make right choices and decisions for themselves. And that's why they're headed down a path of destruction. Because they can't even make right choices. They can't even make right decisions for themselves. That's why the church is here. That's why people of the light should work together, and we should come to church and learn as much as we can. Because we want to be the answer for the whole people don't have.
That's right.
We are the answer for the people who are dying on their way to hell. That's all us.
Amen.
That's right.
Okay. Y'all are real straight now. I know, Pastor. I don't want to take that responsibility. You win.
You in it.
You're in the game.
You win.
You're in it. He chose you. He didn't save you so you can sit on your laurels and just not do nothing.
Right.
He didn't save you for that reason. He saved you so he can use you. And he's using you even if people are using you. God is using you. You know, God allows certain things to happen, not to pick on you or hurt you, but he uses those things to build you up and to help somebody else out along the way.
Amen.
I wish I had some praise.
Amen.
Y'all think that folk just using you.
Nah.
Y'all think the people just treating you bad and treating you nasty.
Nope.
That's not the deal. God is doing something in the scheme of things.
That's right.
He allowed it to happen.
Amen.
Y'all remember I just preached about the wheels. He got this will to do this. He got this will to do that. He got this will to do that. He already know what you're going through. He already know what you're facing.
Yes.
You got to make up in your mind, okay, Lord, I hear you. And okay, if this is to bring glory and honor to your name, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do this one.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I know you got me.
Uh-huh.
You said you'd never leave me nor forsake me. I'm going to hold you to your word.
Amen.
And all you got to do is hold him to his word.
Amen.
Oh, God is going to honor his word. That's one thing about the Lord. He never goes back on a deal.
That's right.
Once God makes a deal with you, that's it.
Right.
You can count on it. He never goes back on his word. Isaiah 55 says, when I send my word forth, it will accomplish what I called it to do.
Yeah.
It will not return to me forward. It won't come back.
That's right.
It will accomplish something.
Right.
I love the word of God. That's why y'all need to know the word of God.
Right.
You need to know what it says concerning your circumstances.
Yeah.
Then you won't be caught up and confused by what Satan is trying to make you feel otherwise.
Yeah.
Satan is always counterfeiting God. That's all you got to know.
Yeah.
That's discernment.
That's right.
Satan is always the counterfeit of God. Always, just like counterfeit money.
Yeah,
that's right.
But you got to be able to discern if it's real money or fake money.
Come on.
Come on now.
You got to be able to discern it.
That's right.
Huh? Because some of us don't know fake money from real money when we see it.
That's right.
But guess what? God will alert you. He'll let you know that ain't real money. That ain't real money. Huh? That's monopoly money. Take that back where you got it from and get some real money. I'm just saying. Okay, y'all. Let me give y'all these 8 points and move on. I'm trying to move y'all. I see I'm gonna be coming back to this. I have to set it up for you guys. But first of all, this is why discernment matters. First of all, it matters because it gives you the ability to recognize God's voice.
My Lord.
Okay, amen. Because you know what? Right now, y'all might got a dozen voices in your head.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
Some of y'all are still listening to that song in your head that Shania just played. That song is still ringing a tune in your head. Mm-hmm. Because that's what it does. Uh-huh. Some of y'all are listening to people on TV. Some of y'all right now, you're thinking about Oprah Winfrey and something she said. Pastor, it's matching what you said. No, it's not. But you got the voice in your head. People, you know, I remember my mom. I remember what my mama said, so-and-so. I remember what my daddy said, so-and-so. All that's fine and dandy, if it's right.
If it's
good, if it's right, if it's beneficial, if it's something that brings no harm and no hurt to nobody else.
Yeah.
But listen, a lot of people are saying stuff and it's empty words.
Yes.
Just a bunch of noise. Paul called it this. Paul said, listen, Paul said if you don't have love, I don't care what you say and how you do it. It's plain and simple. Bang, bang, bang. You ain't doing it with making noise. Bang, bang, bang. It's like simple. Bang, bang, bang. All you're doing is talking. Bang, bang, bang. Come on, y'all know some people.
Bang, bang, bang.
All right, y'all got to believe me. Recognize the voice of God to discover and feel the Lord's plan for our lives. We must be able to hear his voice in Jeremiah 29, verse 11. One of my favorite verses of scripture in the Old Testament says, I have a plan for you. That knocks out your plan.
That's right.
I mean, you can plan. Don't get it twisted now. Don't get me wrong. You can plan and you can prepare. But have you consulted the one that says he has a plan for you first?
Yeah.
Because first and foremost, that's what he says. I got a plan for you. It's not to bring you any harm, but it's to prosper you. And it's to build you up, it's to bring you on up. Yes.
Yes.
He says he has a plan for you, but do you hear that voice though?
No.
Suppose you ask him to guide you in making a decision when a sense of direction comes, and can you tell whether it's from God or your own mind? And if you seek advice from a fellow believer, can you determine if the Lord is speaking through him? And watch this, without discernment, you don't know for sure, and as a result, might take numerous wrong turns in life if you don't hear the voice of God.
My Lord.
My people take the wrong turns and they make the wrong moves because they don't hear from the Lord. Guess what? Don't wait. You know, we're in this techno age. And so we want everything instant. We want everything quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Yeah.
God is the type of God that tells you straight up and down, wait on me.
Wait.
See, we don't want to do that. Because we got to have it done right now. It's not that important, y'all. You got to have it right now. It's not that important. It really isn't that important that you got to have it right now.
Come on now.
Now, but Pastor, you just don't know. You don't understand. I'm getting ready to get put out. I don't know what's going to happen in the next few days if I don't come in. You don't have to worry about it. This is the type of God we serve. He'll send somebody to you that hour of
my Lord.
Great God from Zion.
My Lord.
With a blank check, tell you to fill in the numbers, and you will never see them again.
My Lord.
God will just show up like that, and he'll show you.
Yeah.
I told you, I got this, I got you.
That's right.
But you got to believe him, trust him, have faith in him, and know his voice. Number two, to discern God's will. The reason why you discernment matters is because you need to learn how to discern God's will for your life. You know, I dealt with that for a while. I dealt with the will of God concerning us, and I dealt with God's will, period. His will for us. And so you need to be able to discern God's will when he's in the scheme of things. While the Bible, in some respects, speaks definitively about how to live, it doesn't directly cover every situation. And it doesn't. For example, no verse will tell you whom to marry or whether to move or whether to get a new job.
My Lord.
The Bible won't tell you that. The Bible did not tell you who to marry. The Bible did not tell you to move to nothing. The Bible did not tell you to leave your job and go seek a new job. The Bible don't tell you that. Those are decisions that you have to make. Those are things that you have to determine based on the will of God for your life. You have to determine that. He doesn't give it to you, like speak to you audibly and say, I want you to move to New Jersey. He doesn't tell us that. But this doesn't mean that God is silent on all the issues. Although your particular situation may not be mentioned in scripture, biblical principles cover every decision you will ever make or face. Biblical principles cover every decision you will ever face or make because of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit dwelling within you is there to guide us to the right understanding of how to apply God's word. In Psalms 119, verse 105, it gives you these words. Your word is a lamp. Your word is a lamp. It is a light. It is to light my path.
Yes, sir.
So that means that he will direct you. He will guide you. You got to apply that word to your living. All right, discernment matters. Watch this. Worldly thinking will overpower spiritual discernment if we spend 2 or 3 hours in front of the television and only 10 minutes in the Bible. So guess what? You'll never learn the will of God if you always watching television shows. You know, some of y'all like game shows, some of y'all like soap operas. Y'all will spend 2 or 3 hours watching TV. Some of y'all will watch TV all day long without getting up. Take a bathroom break, get a drink of water, come back and watch the rest of that movie. But won't spend 10 minutes with God. And so how do you think you're going to learn what God has for you if you won't even give him no time? But you give the world all the time. Y'all can go in Walmart for 4 or 5 hours and not buy nothing. I'll wait for the amen. Well, I don't even know what I came here anyway.
You ain't had no money.
I'm just... 5 hours? You ain't purchased nothing. Gonna give him 10 minutes of prayer, 10 minutes of meditating, 10 minutes of studying his word. How you gonna know his will? How you gonna know his will if you think you're gonna get it from me? I'm gonna teach you and I'm gonna preach the gospel and I'm gonna teach you and I'm gonna do the best I can, but guess what? I gotta get mine. I'm sorry. And yes, I do worry about you, and yes, I do care if you get it or you don't get it, but guess what? I gotta get mine. I gotta get mine. Some things are more important than other things.
That's right.
And so I've been talking to y'all about prerogatives and priorities. And so this is a new year. You're in the 12th day of the second month. You ought to start thinking about your priorities over your prerogatives.
Well.